Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which Hive, Sqoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. Let us understand how we can actually start using Sqoop as part of the labs. For this also, I am connecting to the gateway of the cluster using the username and the gateway node details that are provided here, which is nothing but dw03.itbusty.com in my case. If it prompts for the password, we have to copy this password and paste it so that we can log into the gateway node of the cluster. As I have set up passwordless login, I should be able to say SSH training at dw03.itbusty.com. And I should be able to connect to the gateway node of the cluster. To validate whether we have Sqoop or not, we just have to say Sqoop help, and it will actually give us high level commands if Sqoop is set up properly on this environment. So you will be seeing a bunch of Sqoop high level commands such as create hive table, export, import, import all tables, list databases, list tables, etc. So using these commands, you should be able to get metadata of the tables that are part of MySQL, and also you can use import to import the data. So in this case, let's say I want to validate whether I am able to connect to ms.itbusty.com database using retail underscore user and see what all databases that retail underscore user have access to. For that, I can say Sqoop list databases and then hyphen hyphen connect. If JDBC jar file is set up properly, then we should be able to say JDBC colon MySQL colon slash slash ms.itbusty.com. And then colon 3306, which is nothing but port number on which MySQL server is running. If it is default port number, we don't need to specify here. However, if it is using any other port number than 3306, we have to specify. With 3306, either you can specify or you can ignore. Then we have to pass username, which is nothing but retail underscore user, and then hyphen hyphen password, which is nothing but ITVarsity. Using this information, we should be able to get all the databases for which retail user have access to. It will not specify what type of permissions we have on these databases, but as retail underscore user have access to these two databases along with information schema, those are listed here. To list the tables, we can use Sqoop list tables. And while listing the tables, we have to provide the database name. For that, I can say hyphen hyphen connect, blah, 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 and then say retail underscore DB so that we can list the tables from retail underscore DB database. And then username is nothing but retail underscore user and password is nothing but ITVarsity. Now we should be able to list the tables also. Like this, we can actually validate whether we are able to access the databases using the JDBC URL for which we have access to. So in this case, MySQL is running on ms.itvarsity.com where there are multiple databases. And using retail underscore user, we are able to validate the databases for which it have access to. And also for a given database, we actually listed the tables as well. We'll actually deep dive into rest of the Sqoop commands as part of the Sqoop topic in our course. For now, this is good enough to validate that we are able to access the databases using Sqoop.